Tonight, we're back with attorney Michael Avenatti. He is a main player in what we learned today from Michael Cohen and what it means going forward. He stood in open court today and said, yes, I committed crimes. Two of them, felonies, campaign finance. I did them at the direction of a candidate for federal office, also known as Donald Trump. What did you think when you heard that?
Well, I thought that we made a giant leap forward relating to our civil case in multiple ways. First of all, there's little doubt now that we're going to get a deposition of Michael Cohen in connection with our case. You know, on September 10th, we have a hearing where the judge is going to make a determination as to whether to lift the stay or the pause in the case that Michael Cohen had demanded while this criminal investigation played out. Well, now it's basically been resolved. So we would expect judge on the 10th of September to lift that pause, allow the case to proceed. And we have a pending motion to depose Michael Cohen and Donald Trump. I think there's zero chance we don't get a deposition of Michael Cohen. And I think there's a significant likelihood that we're going to get a deposition of Donald Trump. And so what that's going to mean is that I'm going to have an opportunity to ask Michael Cohen and Donald Trump questions under oath. Under oath. You know, it's one thing to lie to you or other members of the press. It's an entirely different thing to lie under oath. I'm going to get a chance to ask some very difficult questions of Michael Cohen and Donald Trump about what they knew, when they knew it, what they did about it, and what they did to cover it up.
Cohen, much more of a straight line analysis. He asked for the stay. We've all read, those who are following this, we get what that was about. That may be over. I don't see anything in the plea deal that stops him from being in action. And in fact, they say the opposite, which is it doesn't forestall any other legal activities that are out of the bounds of this agreement. Not a straight line analysis for the president. Not easy to get him for a deposition. What precedent do you point to? Do you believe that Clinton is any analogy for you?
Yeah, absolutely. The Supreme Court's decision, Jones v. Clinton, we believe is on all fours with this case, meaning it serves as solid precedent for the idea that you can seek and get an order allowing you to depose a sitting president for conduct occurring before he or she was sworn into office. And that's exactly what we're talking about here.
What is chance that if you have President Trump in the chair, he is able to avoid acknowledging that he knew about what was going on with Stormy Daniels, that either that it was what Stormy Daniels says it was during the pendency of the actual relationship, and that the arrangements that came thereafter is something he was aware of at the time?
Well, I mean, I think as we've witnessed over the last 2.5 years, I mean, this is a man that'll say or do anything, literally anything, even if it has no basis in the truth. But I will tell you that I think one of the last things that Donald Trump wants to have is me sitting across the table from him, asking him questions under oath. I would also put Bob Mueller in the same category. This president, who is a habitual liar, wouldn't know the truth if it fell off a building and hit him in the head, would have a very difficult time in a sworn deposition where he's asked very pointed questions and is forced to answer questions and provide the truth.
If Michael Cohen is telling the truth today in court, and I know people will say, well, he's an admitted liar. Mm-hmm. Yeah, he also has tons of motivation to not lie about this right now, because they'll pull this deal from him. It's very tenuous and attenuated to his complying in every way, including telling the truth today in court during his allocution. It's actually mentioned in the plea deal as one of the bases for the agreement. That would mean that this president lied to us again and again and again about criminal conduct relevant to you?
100%. I mean, all you have to do is go back and look at the president's statement aboard the People's Plane, otherwise known as Air Force One, not long ago. He was pointedly asked questions by the Associated Press reporter relating to what he knew about the payment. And he basically said he didn't know anything about it. And he pointed everybody to Michael Cohen and said, talk to my attorney. Basically said, if you want to know the facts, go talk to my attorney. Well, guess what? Today, in open court in the Southern District of New York, we heard from his attorney. We heard the facts from his attorney. And those facts are directly counter to what Donald Trump told America aboard Air Force One. They are completely contrary. You cannot reconcile what Donald Trump has stated publicly and what Michael Cohen said in open court today. And that is a